And first at 6, on the eve of Dayton's State of the City address, we are cutting through the red tape to see if the goals of last year's address have been met.
We asked Mayor Nan Whaley directly about what she's accomplished and what is still ahead. Kelly King working for you, holding the mayor accountable for the promises made. Kelly?
Ahead of tomorrow's State of the City, I caught up with Mayor Nan Whaley. I reviewed some of her initiatives from last year, and I looked into her efforts and accomplishments since last year's address. After speaking with her, while I found out improvements have been made, there's still a lot more work that needs to be done in our city.
We have lots more work to do and lots more initiatives, and so we're excited to take a moment to celebrate those actions the past year and talk about what we have coming up this coming year.
Mayor Nan Whaley says education and business are just some of the topics she plans to address in her State of the City Wednesday. In her 2014 address, Mayor Whaley unveiled a City of Learners Committee. Its goal? To break down barriers to children's success in school and help improve education here. I asked about her progress.
Talk to me about how you would grade yourself and the goals that you've met.
Oh, thank you. Well, we're really pleased with the progress we've made last year.
According to the City of Learners Action Report, Whaley's committee created a Turnaround Schools Task Force. It's designed to help failing schools and provide students with the foundation needed to go to college or to start a career. At the end of the 2013-2014 school year, the Dayton School Board closed two low-performing schools, Gardendale and Gorman, and Rosa Parks Pre-K through 8 was repurposed as a high-quality preschool. The mayor says in the coming year, she will continue to focus on education, something she says is critical for our area.
And why is that so important for Dayton?
Well, because, you know, in addition to having a healthy community, we need to have an educated community too. If we want to have a good paying, high quality job, jobs in the city of Dayton and in the region, we have to have a strong workforce. It's so key to our economic development, our vitality.
During the past year, Whaley has also worked to make Dayton more business friendly. Through her efforts, small businesses along North Main Street and in the Oregon District, like Brim and Press, have been welcomed. Whaley says there's still much more to be accomplished.
We're excited about the work that we've done in the community and definitely talking to businesses and talking to the top 25 employers. All stuff we'll talk at the State of the City tomorrow, so I hope to see you there tomorrow.
The State of the City address will take place tomorrow morning at 8:30. Of course, 2 News will be there and bring you the plans and challenges the mayor has ahead for the new year. Kelly King, 2 News, working for you.